Hey guys, Duke of the Bump here. Today I'll be doing something a little bit different than my usual LP. This is The Binding of Isaac. This was an indie game that was released on PC last year, and it was made in part by Edmund McMillen, who was one of the main guys behind Super Meat Boy. You'll probably recognize the art style. And the best way to describe this game is a hybrid between a roguelike, a dual-stick shooter, and the original Legend of Zelda on the NES. Just a warning, this is going to be a spoiler-filled video. Basically, this is intended for people who are familiar with the game and who want to see a relatively high-level playthrough. So if you're interested in this game at all, I would highly recommend just downloading it on Steam. It's like $5, and giving it a try. It is a great game. It's my game of 2011, my favorite game that was released last year. And last year had some pretty good games, but I won't bother showing the intro. If you are watching this and you're not familiar with the game, just a very brief summary of the story. Well, there's not really much to the story. Basically, you play Isaac, and your mom goes crazy and hears the voice of God instructing her to kill her son, instructing her to kill Isaac, which, you know, obviously you can see the biblical allegory there. And Isaac escapes into his basement through a trapdoor in his floor, and his basement, as it turns out, is the entrance to a horrible nightmare world filled with monsters and a pretty disturbing set of, well, you'll see once I get into it. I've actually already beaten this game 5 times. Well, technically 6, it's just the first time doesn't really count. There are 9 endings to the game, and I've gotten the first 5. I actually recorded an entire playthrough of this game, and you know, I was shocked because I wasn't expecting to actually make it through. You know, I wasn't expecting to actually beat the game when I was recording, so I was pretty thrilled about that until I realized that the recording screwed up 15 minutes into it. So yeah, I lost like an hour-long video. So I think I have all my settings correct, and I recorded a test video that seemed to do okay. So, yeah, crossing my fingers, and I will go ahead and jump into it. Isaac is the main basic character you start with. He starts with no special items or abilities, and he has the base stats. And really, I don't like playing with Isaac. There are other characters that you can unlock by accomplishing various tasks throughout the game. Magdalene's pretty good. She's slow and less powerful than Isaac, but she has more health, and she starts with an item that lets you refill a heart every so often. This is the character I recommend for people starting out, once they unlock her, of course. These other characters, Eve, she's okay. She starts with some good stuff, but I don't really care that much for her. Judas is just terrible. He's like the joke character of the game because he starts with one heart, which makes the game pretty much impossible. Cain is my go-to character for this game. He starts with 2 hearts, which it just has 1 here, but he starts with 2. And he's faster and stronger than Isaac starting out, even though he starts with less health. But it's still 2's better than 1. He also starts with an item, which makes one of the power-ups you can collect through the game, the pill. Normally you have a chance of getting a good pill or a bad pill, and when you play Cain, you're always guaranteed to get a good pill, which is extremely helpful. So, despite the low health, the low starting health, Cain is my man. If you can survive through the first couple levels, you can usually find quote-unquote heart containers that make the low health no longer an issue. So yeah, I will go on ahead and start a new game with Cain. And as you can see, the layout in the top left-hand corner is very similar to the dungeons in the original Legend of Zelda. Of course, the roguelike aspect comes into the dungeons themselves, which are completely randomized. So, this dungeon is different than any other dungeon I've ever played. The layout is different, the monsters are different, and all the items that you find are different, which makes the game really infinitely replayable. And, you know, that's why you can play this game 9 times, or beat the game 9 times, and not get sick of it. Just because it's different, you know, exciting every time. This is a locked door to the south, at least to the item shop, which I won't open that yet, because I don't have any money. If I do find money before the end of the level, I might go ahead and go in there, but at the moment, there's no point in wasting a key to get in there. And that room to the left is the item room, which you can tell by the gold outline on the door. On every level except the first, the item room requires a key to get into, but on the first level, you basically get one item for free. And, of course, we get a pretty crappy item here starting out, the Lemon Mishap. All this does is, when you hit the space bar, well, let me go into a room with monsters and I shall demonstrate. Oh, no monsters in here. Basically, when you hit the space bar, it creates a little puddle on the floor, which is lemonade, as you can probably guess, that deals damage to any monsters who happen to walk through it. And it's really a small puddle, not particularly useful, but it recharges fairly quickly. Like here, for example, doesn't even do me any good because these are flying enemies. I just used it just for the hell of it so I can show the recharge mechanic. Basically, once you defeat every enemy in a room, whatever item you have in your inventory recharges X amount. And with the Lemon Mishap, it's a pretty crappy item, so it actually recharges. It only takes 2 rooms to recharge it to full. And as you can see, it just recharged halfway there. It would probably be useful against these guys, since being headless, they just tend to kind of stumble around randomly. But they shouldn't be too difficult to take care of. Now, as you can see, there is a chest in the corner of this room that I am unable to get to. But I do have a bomb that I can use to destroy these rocks and get to the chest. However, I think instead of that, I will use my bomb over here. I didn't point this out at the time, but there is a bombable block here, which you can tell because it's, well, they're all bombable, but this is a block that contains an item, which you can tell because it's differently colored and has a little X on it. And so I will place my bomb there and hopefully get something good. Yes, excellent, I got something very good. I got the bomb, I replaced the bomb that I used, and I got the small rock, which significantly increases your damage. Let's go ahead and take a look at the stats screen here. Here we have your speed, and this is the number of arrows you fire, or rather the speed of your projectiles. This is your damage, which started out here and is now here. So yeah, already almost full damage, which is excellent. And this is your range, which starts off as low as possible. Hopefully we will be increasing all of these stats throughout the course of the game, but that is a very good item to find this early on, and it'll probably make the boss a lot easier. Since we replaced the bomb that we used, we can go on ahead and bomb this group of blocks so we can get to that chest as well. And we get a key and a soul heart. A soul heart is basically just a temporary hit point. Once I get hit twice, it's gone. But there's no limit to the number of those that you can collect. And here we have our first boss. And the bosses are also randomized. There are a number of different possibilities. Here we have the Duke of Flies. One of the easier bosses in the game. He is just a floating blob who spits out flies. And they don't really pose that much of a threat. And especially with my increased damage, I'm taking all these guys out pretty handily. And every time you beat a boss, you get an item from the boss as well. The Soul Heart is just a nice bonus that he dropped. The item that we got for beating the boss is the heals, which increases your range. Maybe this one is the range and this one is the speed of the projectiles. I don't know, that doesn't make sense, because you would think the multiple arrows indicate the number of arrows that you're firing, so strange. But you can see our range on our tiers has been increased a little bit. I haven't really explained, you know, the lore of this game. Your tiers are your weapon, and there are other weapons that you can get to replace the tiers. The power-ups in the game are all based on either hurting or humiliating poor little Isaac. As you can see, the small rock is just a rock lodged in her head, and it can get pretty dark. You can probably already tell, but this game doesn't pull any punches when it comes to gross symbolism or, you know, disturbing imagery. One of the power-ups you can get is actually a bent coat hanger stuck through your head. And you can get a spoon, which places little red spoon marks all over your body, and that increases the power of your tears. And it can get pretty graphic, so let me get that mouse cursor out of the way. So yeah, if you are squeamish, then you should probably stop watching now, because it's not going to get any better. Between every floor, you have a little interlude showing one of Isaac's mini nightmares. Wow, that is a lot of enemies on the screen. Luckily, these guys are not very threatening. As long as you keep your distance, their little blood spurts probably aren't going to do much damage. And, you know, they don't actually come after you, they just kind of walk around randomly. This is one of the pills that I mentioned, and as you can see up in the right-hand corner there, you can press Q to activate the pills. Let me go over here and see what these pills do. Okay. That pill was just bad gas. When you use it, it basically immediately, I think it poisons any enemies in the little burst radius there, or it does a little bit of damage. Not very useful, since I usually wait until after the room is clear before I use any pills, just in case it's explosive diarrhea, which is why I moved over here. One of the pills you can get basically drops 5 bombs in a row that are already lit, and if you're not careful, you can kind of screw yourself. And the reason I moved over here, just in case I did get explosive diarrhea, then if there's a secret passage in this wall, then it would blow a door open so I could get to that secret room. Not very likely, but there are a lot of little strategies you can use in this game to prolong your survival and make things easier on you, and that's just one of them. Not terribly important, but something I like to do anyway. That was the chunk of meat, one of the more annoying enemies in the game. Just kind of quivers around, firing in all 4 directions, making him a little difficult to hit. Here we have the Mulligan, and a harder form of the Mulligan. Any enemy in the game, you have a chance of fighting a harder version of, which you can tell because, you know, that one was dark green in color instead of the normal gray color, and also the sprite was slightly larger. And here, I don't know what most of these enemies are called, just a heads up. Once you beat the game, it gives you an enemy scroll, like at the end of Super Mario 2, that shows all the enemies and what their names are and whatnot, but I didn't memorize all of them. There are several enemies in this game. I mean, there's a ton, and there are a lot of variations on the different enemies, which keeps it pretty interesting. Changes. Oh, damn it! I walked right into that one. it requires you to change up your strategy a lot, and damn, I just totally lost my train of thought. Oh well. Here we have another item room, which is locked, but luckily we have four keys. And here, I actually don't know if I've gotten this item before. The Necronomicon. I might have gotten it once, but I have no idea what it does. Which is the amazing thing about this game. The more you beat it, the more items you unlock that you potentially have a chance of picking up in the item rooms, and, you know, as treasure when you beat the bosses. And the Necronomicon is one I don't think I've actually gotten it before at all. So, this is a pretty safe room, so let's see what it does. Wow, it just killed every enemy in the room. I don't know if that's just because they were flies and they're just weak, and normally it just damages every enemy in the room, but that looks like a pretty good one. I think I will hold on to this one for a while. You can only keep one item in your inventory at a time. Well, one activated item and one consumable. So one like the Necronomicon and one pill or a tarot card. Oh, this is one of the mini bosses you can face based on the seven deadly sins. This is a gluttony. Kind of a pain in the ass. Nothing too difficult. That little starburst attack is kind of a pain, but I took him out no problem. And we got more pills, so let's activate it. Ooh, health up. Very nice. One of the best pills you can get. It's essentially a free heart container. So, yeah. I will remember that one. Well, once you use a pill, it tells you in the future when you pick up that kind of pill. Instead of just being question marks, it actually has a name. And the Necronomicon is already halfway charged, so I doubt it actually kills every enemy on the screen, because that would take significantly longer to recharge. It's probably just damaged all the enemies, and since they were just flies, then they just couldn't sustain that much damage. But yeah, still a very nice item. And this is another relatively easy boss, Larry Jr. A pair of worms who defecate all over the place. And their pattern is fairly random. They don't really come after you. The random movements can be a little tricky, but it is easy enough to avoid. You have to make sure you don't get trapped by the poop, which can be an issue if you find yourself getting surrounded. But yeah, I've pretty much gotten this under control. The extra damage from my small rock is helping considerably. And this is dog food, which is basically another heart container. So as you can see, I've already gone from 2 hearts to 4, and I just now beat the second level of the first area, so I'm doing pretty well. Every now and then, once you beat a boss, another door opens up, which you can go into instead of immediately going down to the next level. And this door leads to Satan. What Satan does is he lets you sell your soul for a power-up. And the little hearts underneath those items mean I can lose 2 hearts permanently and get the nail, or I can lose 1 heart permanently and get the familiar, which I'm not immediately sure what this particular familiar does, but since I'm already doing so well, you know, this early on, and I'd like to make things interesting, let's go on ahead and do it. Oh, Brother Bobby. That's actually a pretty good one. He basically just hovers around you and fires bullets at a pretty fast rate. Not the best familiar you can get, but definitely helpful. And as you can see, I now have 3 hearts instead of 4. Normally, I don't go for selling my soul to the devil at all, just because every heart is, you know, I mean, it's good to have as many hearts as you can, because the game gets extremely hard in the upper levels. I'm not actually planning on beating the game this time. I wasn't planning on beating it last time. I just got pretty lucky, and I found a nice supply of very useful items. I mean, warning you now, I'm probably not going to win. But that's what a roguelike is all about. And there are no continues, you know, no extra lives, nothing like that. Once you die, you're done. You know, that game's over. So, yeah. Let's carry on. We finished the basement, and we are heading into the caves. So far, my items have been fairly disappointing. I mean, the lemon mishap was just, you know, really it's a throwaway. As you can see, I didn't use it at all, other than the one demonstration. The Necronomicon seems pretty nice, but I'm going to have to wait and see how it handles a room full of strong monsters before I really make a judgment. These things are fairly annoying. You can only hit them when they pop up to shoot, and they spread a pretty formidable little bullet spread there. There's another version of those that is, you don't have to wait for them to pop up to hit them, but their bullet spread is larger. And I forgot to mention, there is a pill in the middle of this room that I can't get. There are items in the game that let you maneuver over pits, and I may hopefully find one, because those items are totally useful. But for the moment, that pill is just kind of stuck there. We may come back for it if we find an item. This is a challenge room to my left. When you enter a challenge room, there's an item or a chest in the middle of the room, and once you get it, the door behind you locks and you have to fight three waves of enemies before you can leave. I got the bad gas pill, which I went ahead and used. As you can see, it poisoned that enemy, and it dies shortly afterwards. That's what that green splatter is. Really, the bad gas would be useful if it weren't for the small radius on it. The enemies have to be pretty much right next to you for it to hit, and it's not a good idea to get that close to the enemies, so... these are hives. These are like an evolved form of the mulligan. They run away from you, and they spit out flies, and that's pretty much it. Alright, let's go on ahead and use the Necronomicon and see what happens. Wow. It killed both of those enemies. The only reason it didn't kill that one is because he was still in his shell. So yeah, the Necronomicon looks pretty useful. I'm surprised it recharges that fast, because usually these types of items take like, you know, 6 rooms to recharge. Well, maybe that was about 6 rooms. I wasn't really counting. Damn it. And that was the other version of this enemy with the fire, 5 bullets instead of just 3. I got hit. Unfortunately. The other reason these guys are annoying is because if you just keep firing at them, they'll never pop up. You have to kinda stop and, you know, move away from them to give them a chance to pop up. And item room to the south. Ooh, this is a pretty good one. I'm not sure if I will take it though, but I'll go ahead and demonstrate it. Basically, it is Shoop-de-Whoop. He hits space, and he charges his laser, and he fires his laser, which does pretty decent damage to whatever you shoot it at. Best save for bosses. But I think I'll hold on to the Necronomicon. I want to see how it fares against a boss, because if he kills every enemy on the screen, chances are it's going to do pretty good damage to a boss, which will be useful against some of the tougher bosses. I haven't really fought any tough bosses yet, but I will eventually, presumably. Here we have 2 tarot cards, the World and the Sun. What the World does is, I think it basically, well, I'll go ahead and use it, why not? Yeah, it basically gives you a map of the dungeon you're currently on. And you can see all the rooms that we haven't explored yet. And you can also see the hidden room, which is pretty cool. The sun, I think, does the same thing as the world, but it also heals you to full. And it might even do a little bit of damage to enemies on the screen. So I'll save that one for now. Yeah, let's go into the secret room. We can bomb this wall and get there into a problem. And we have a slot machine. Basically works the way you would think. You bump into it, takes a coin from you, a penny, you pull the lever, and stuff might pop out. I only have 3 coins right now though, so I'm going to leave that there for now. Not one of the better things you can find in a secret room. These are bomb flies. They fly around in a predetermined pattern, and when you kill them, they explode. And when you have this many in a room, they can be pretty nasty because they can start a chain reaction, which if you're not careful, could hurt. And more tiny flies. You probably notice you have 2 varieties of the tiny flies. You have the black ones, which just kind of float there, and the red ones, which are aggressive and actually swarm you. Not a huge deal, but can be a problem. Here we have TNT barrels, which we can blow up and collect these coins. And you would think that I wouldn't be able to get to that stuff in the middle since it's surrounded by holes, but one of the cool things you can do with bombs and TNT barrels is when they blow up rocks, the rubble fills these holes up, so you can walk over the rubble and get whatever's there. Now that I have 7 coins, I think I'm going to go down and check out the item shop. See if there's anything cool in there. With 7 coins, we probably wouldn't be able to buy anything cool unless it's on sale. Yeah, we have the bomb, which just gives you a single bomb, and the virus, which makes it so whenever you touch an enemy, it poisons it. Which you already saw what poison did with the bad gas pill. So yeah, even if I had 15 coins, I probably wouldn't spend it on that. It's useful, but I don't like any items that require you to be close to an enemy. Oh, damn it! I was really hoping that rock would explode in a way that creates a bridge to that little platform there so I can get that chest. Like I was saying, I don't really like any items that require you to get that close to an enemy, so... Ooh, we have a tough boss here, the Fallen. Let's see if the Necronomicon does anything. Not really. Kind of underwhelming there. Whoa! I mean, you would think the Necronomicon wouldn't do that much damage to a demonic enemy anyway, but, whoa. This guy's kind of tough. Oh. And now we have 2 of them. Damn it. I'm still pretty slow, so makes evading these guys a bit difficult. Circle strafing is your friend. If you are not good at circle strafing, you are probably not going to do it. You know what? Let's use the sun. Wow. That did better than I thought. Very cool. And here we have the mark, which increases your curse. What curse does is when you get down to half a heart, you transform into the demonic form of yourself, which is faster, tougher, faster, you deal more damage. Basically, all your stats go up as long as you only have half a heart left. Which, again, it's one of those items that can be useful, but not unless you put yourself in a bad situation in the first place, which, you know, I prefer items that help me avoid getting in a bad situation. I wonder if the Necronomicon didn't do anything, or didn't do that much, just because of what enemy it was. Maybe it'll do more against the other bosses. These guys are... damn it, I don't know what they're called. They are basically meat men who, once you kill them, they don't actually die, they just turn into a little meat blob, and then they reform. So you have to shoot the blob if you want to kill them for good. Why did that do a whole heart to me? I should have only done half a heart. That was weird. Here we have a blood donation machine. What this does is it lets you trade... Oh, well, it's gone anyway. If it was there, it would let me trade hearts for money. Which, if you put enough hearts into it, if you basically... It's kind of a crapshoot. You have a chance of getting a blood bag, but it can be anywhere between 2 and, like, 10 hearts. Well, not that many. 10 half hearts. It can take a lot before you get a blood bag. A blood bag completely heals you and it gives you a heart container, but going for it is very risky, and I don't do it unless I have a lot of health. Here we have another challenge room, but you actually have to be at full health for the challenge room to even open. So I might revisit that later. Oh boy. Ooh, this is gonna suck. Eesh. Luckily, these little floating head guys aren't really that bothersome. You just have to watch when they die because they explode into 4 blood splatters. And we got a bomb from that room. Let's not go to the boss yet. And say I'm doing okay. I probably shouldn't have gotten the familiar. In fact, if I was playing a real game, you know, by myself, I probably wouldn't have done it. But, you know, I was curious. Getting that small rock has definitely helped. We haven't gotten that many other stat-ups, though. I could bomb this rock and go for those coins, but I only have 1 bomb left, so I think I'll leave those there for now. I might come back to it if I get more bombs. These are little ladybugs. Basically, they're like the aggressive flies, except that when you kill them, they explode. We have quite a few keys, so let's go on ahead and see what's in the shop. Aw, man. This is another one of the Deadly Sin mini-bosses, Greed. And this is probably my least favorite of the bunch, because he has this attack, this spread bullet attack, that he doesn't really telegraph that much, and they're pretty fast projectiles. I already got hit by him once. I'll, damn it! See? It is pretty difficult to avoid that. I mean, it's not like he really pauses or anything before he does it. He just kind of... Ah! Okay. And this is what the mark does. I am now Demonic Cane. I am faster. I wonder if that actually increases this stuff. Yeah. My damage is all the way up. My speed's up. I think my range is up. But the downside is, of course, I am extremely vulnerable. Just one more hit and I'm down. Oh boy. Oh boy. Well, let's use this. I think that would be a good idea in this situation. Hopefully there will be something health related in this room. Otherwise I might be in trouble. Oh, that is actually extremely helpful. The Yum Heart. This is the item that Magdalene starts with. You can hit space to heal yourself. And now that I have more health, once I leave this room, I won't be in demonic form. I think it only takes like 3 rooms to recharge the Yum Heart too, so I'm going to hang on to that, as nice as the Necronomicon is. I am kind of hurting for health at the moment. And these are the bad floating heads. These are the ones that shoot at you repeatedly instead of just floating there waiting to die. Okay, well, I'm out of the danger zone and I still can't get to that challenge room. I could head over to the right to see what's in this direction, even though I already have the item room. On lower levels, I usually try to explore every room, even once I find the boss and once I already have the item. Just because the rooms aren't that challenging, and you still might get some useful items from them. In the upper levels, it's generally advisable to go to the boss as soon as possible, just because, you know, you're much more likely to lose health before you get to the boss in those instances. But for now, we can explore a little bit and take out those hives. Oh, fuck! I was too close to that barrel. Damn it. Okay. Oh boy. Alright. I might go quiet in some of these difficult rooms. Okay, we got half a heart and we can use our young heart again, so we're good. This door leads to the arcade. You have a blood donation machine, you have the slot machine, and you have the, the shell game, I guess. Give him a coin, he shows you an item, and you have a chance of getting that item, or you have a chance of getting the fly. I think another benefit to playing Kane is that you actually have a higher chance of winning at this. I think you have a 50-50 chance instead of just a, a 1 in 3 chance. I'm not 100% certain, though. I could keep pumping coins into this, but I don't have that many coins, and I'd like to save them just in case there's something good on the next level to buy. Some of the best items you can find in the item shops pretty frequently, like the ladder, which lets you go over single holes like this. Very useful. There's the battery, which makes your item recharge more quickly, which with a yum heart would just be excellent. So yeah, I'll hold on to what I have. Okay, this is just Chubb. He is one of the less threatening bosses in the game. Basically, he's just a bigger version. Oh shit, a bigger version of the maggots that we've been fighting the whole time. And he spawns the small maggots, and that's pretty much all he does. He spawns maggots and he charges at you. So, not too much of a threat. There are harder versions of Chubb. Well, there's harder versions of every boss. There's a version of Chubb that rather than spawning maggots, will spawn little, they're like little pustules, I guess, that just kind of sit there, but the fire will set you extremely quickly. Yeah. Damn it. This is a pretty gross game. Pretty gross. And I'm back down to half a heart, so gotta concentrate. Woo! Alright, just gotta take these little buggers out. And I'm good to go. Pick up some health. And this is the aforementioned coat hanger, which increases the power of your tears. Which, right now, we are at max because we're in demon form, but once I switch back, my tears should be much better than they were. Yeah, still at max. Wow, excellent. And they're pretty fast, too. See? This has to be projectile speed. Oh well. And we are in the depths. This is where the game starts getting really fun. If I die, it'll probably be here. Since I don't have that much extra health, and I don't know how good my odds are to make it to the next area. These enemies are a pain in the ass. They slide around and they leave a radioactive substance behind that hurts you if you walk over it. Let's see. See what's down here. Oh, fuck. Oh, boy. Alright, Matt. It's go time. Can't let these guys get the best of you. Ooh, slow down. But I took out all those flies in one shot, which is pretty good. Alright, let's see what's in the item shop. Ooh! The mini mushroom. Makes you smaller, harder to hit, also makes you faster, and increases the range of your tears. Very nice. I could see what this tarot card is, or get a soul heart. Actually, I think I will go for that soul heart, since I'm pretty low on health. I was hoping that would be the odd mushroom, which confers a whole bunch of stat-ups to you. But no. Oh. Fuck, I hate these guys. Most annoying enemy in the game. The Knight. Similar to the Dark Nut from Legend of Zelda, you can only hit them in their exposed brain in the back of their head. and their movement pattern makes them extremely unpredictable and very difficult to kill. If I still had my Necronomicon, I would definitely pull it out now. But without much health, the Yumheart is definitely the more useful item overall. Oh fuck, see? That guy just turned around. Gotta be more careful, Matt. I mean, Duke. Why would I call myself Matt? That's not my name. Ha! I'm so crazy. Oh fuck. Oh shit. Oh. There are items in the game that make your projectiles go through enemies, which make these things trivial to take care of, but I have not been lucky enough to find one. We have another new pill. Let's see what it does. Bombs are key. That trades the number of bombs you have with the number of keys you currently have. Or, I should say, it switches, not trades. But we had 6 of each, so it doesn't really do anything for us in this situation. I will go ahead and use my Yumheart. Oh, seriously? Jesus. Unfortunately, we have to clear the room before we can go down into the item room, where there's potentially... Oh, shit. Where there's potentially something that can help us. Yeah, you don't really start encountering the really bad enemies until the depths. That's where the real assholes start to come out. Okay. Let's bomb that block. Ooh. Pretty nice. I didn't pick up that heart because I was only half a heart down. And, I would have wasted half a heart if I got it. Which was good because I found 2 half hearts in this chest. Alright. Come on, good item. Oh, the doctor's remote. I think what this does is you basically use it and it gives you like a little reticule. I'll come back for the heart. I want to see exactly what this does. Yeah, it gives you a little reticule that you can position, and then it drops a bomb and it explodes. Which, it's okay. Usually I'm too busy worrying about dodging to try to position a reticule, so definitely not preferable to the heart. Okay, and here we have the little stone head in the center of the room that fires blood at you, and they don't go away until every enemy in the room is dead. And you can't kill them, you can't blow them up, they are just there to annoy you until you clear the room. Oh, these are the little pustule things I was talking about. Very annoying. Once they, if they're small, then they don't do anything, but once they grow to full size, they just start spewing blood just everywhere. Another new pill. Let us find out what it does. Okay, that's the explosive diarrhea one. And as you can see, I moved up to the top of the room, just in case there was a secret passage there, but there wasn't. No point in using a bomb to get that bomb, so should I check out the rest of this place? I already got the item and the shop, so there's really no point in continuing. However, I do want to fully recharge my heart before I go after the boss. Excuse me. Oh, this is pretty good. Ooh, the High Priestess. Pretty good tarot card. And here in the center of the room, we have the Beggar. What the Beggar does is he just asks for money, and he has a chance of giving you an item. Here we got the Halo of Flies, which is a pretty damn good item. Basically, those 2 flies deal damage to anything they touch, and they block projectiles. Not much damage. I think they're strong enough to kill flies. But that's it. And, they do minor damage to other enemies. So another one of those situations where you don't really want to be that close in the first place. But the projectile blocking is extremely useful. I can't tell you how many times I've had my ass saved numerous times because I had things floating around me that made me more difficult to hit. I could use the High Priestess here, but I will save it for the boss, I believe. It is one of the better damage-dealing tarot cards you can get. Plus, these guys are a pushover. All you gotta do is walk around in a circle. I say that and I get hit. Oh well, there's a heart down there I can collect. These guys are actually faster than usual. I think that's changed based on the number of times I've beaten the game. Also, it seems like I'm taking more damage than I should be. I don't know why. Okay. I want to go back for those hearts, and then I'm just going to head to the boss. I could explore those other rooms, but I'm not feeling too confident in my survival ability at the moment. So I'm just going to press on. Man, I'm fast. Let's see what my stats are at. Wow, my speed really isn't even that high. I think sometimes you can get stats that don't actually show up in your stats. And that's what happened that one time I got the range up, and this one didn't increase. I don't know. It's weird. Alright, we have a fully charged Yum Heart. We have the High Priestess. Let's see what we got. Loki. One of the more annoying bosses. Let's use the High Priestess. Squish. And that did... well, it did almost all of its health and damage, which is amazing. Made that so simple. And this is basically just another heart container. Excuse me. Alright, well, let's soldier on. I've seen all these, which is why I just usually skip them, but I should show them for the video. Oh boy. Okay. This sucks, but it is doable. Of course, there are items you can get that make that blood no longer a problem, but I haven't gotten lucky enough to get those either. These are smaller forms of the Gluttony mini-boss that we fought earlier. Basically, it's exactly the same, except that that's their only attack. They don't have the spread of bullets that Gluttony has. Still kind of a pain in the ass to deal with, Temperance. I think that spawns either a beggar or a blood machine. Yeah, it's a blood machine. Strength is basically just a stat increase for one room. It increases your health, your speed, your attack, all that stuff. So, nice to hang on to. These are guts. They just kind of roll around whatever object they're attached to. And the thing moving around was I think it's called a pokey. It's just an obstacle that you have to deal with until you clear the room. Guts can be difficult to deal with, but this is a pretty easy room to find guts in. And we got another explosive diarrhea, so let's try to use it to our advantage. If there's a secret room over there, then... nope. Whoa. That was weird. I didn't drop them all at once. It kind of saved that one. Huh. Oh well. Let's go ahead and use our Yum Heart. Oh shit. You can... whoa, god, that guy's fast. You can try to bomb these guys as well, but their erratic pattern makes that... well, I actually got pretty lucky there. Their erratic pattern makes bombs less useful than they would otherwise be. And this guy, instead of a brain in the back, he has an Isaac mask, which basically the only difference is when he's actually coming towards you, he's a little bit faster. And this is the powered up version of that, which you can tell because he's green. I could try to bomb him, but that would be kind of a crapshoot. So, since he's the only enemy left in this room, I will just Tough it out. God, I hate these guys so much. And all I got from that was a stupid key and a stupid coin. Figures. Oh boy. Okay, that could have been worse. I could go to the arcade, but I will save my coins until I see what's on the item shop for this floor. Or what's in the item shop, rather. Oh shit. See? There, I probably should have gotten hit, but I think my halo saved me. Oh boy. Alright, just one more. Okay, excellent. Excellent, okay. Let's see what we got. Oh god, another one? Seriously? Ugh. I didn't think you could even get the 7 Deadly Sin bosses more than once per game. Okay, well, at least I'm powerful enough where it's not really an issue. All these coins are great. It'd be nice if there was a shop somewhere for where I can spend them. Oh god, I hate these guys. They teleport, they make a really obnoxious sound. They're easy enough to dodge, though. By the way, I apologize for the loud clacking on my keyboard. I have a, it's a DOS keyboard with the buckling spring technology, which I love typing on. You know, I love a really tactile auditory experience, but it makes this kind of game, oh shit, makes this kind of game, you know, loud for the video. Alright, these guys are trapped in their little corner, so this should be pretty easy to deal with. Just gotta be careful. Try not to cross the streams. So yeah, what have I been up to lately? Well, funny you ask. I moved recently. I am now living by myself, which means I am much less self-conscious when it comes to recording these kinds of things. Because I don't have to worry about possibly people coming through the room, through my room, to get to the laundry room. Which means I can record as much as I want with impunity and no one will hear me. Just go ahead and use that. Huh. That's weird. It's letting me into the challenge room anyway, even though my regular hearts are completely full. Well, I guess it counts as soul heart for this. So yeah, if you hear sirens in the background, I'm not really in the best part of town at the moment, which is fine. I mean, I've lived in worse places, and honestly, I'm just glad to be living on my own, because, you know, I'm 26 years old. I should be, you know, it's weird to still be living with family when you're 26, so, yeah, definitely moving up in the world. Oh, shit. This is a... Oh, my God. I forgot about these guys. These are a version... Oh, shit. Of an enemy we saw earlier in the game. That has a really, really horrible attack where it jumps up in the air and sprays blood everywhere. It's probably going to come down right on your head. God, look at how fast these guys are. See, that's the thing. This game gets a little bit more difficult every time you play it. Enemies are faster, some of them do more damage, I think. I still haven't really sussed out exactly how this game works. There's a pretty thorough wiki, which I've been trying to avoid for the most part. Just because, you know, the thing that's great about this game is the thrill of discovery, you know? You're constantly finding new stuff. So yeah, I mean, I have used the wiki a couple times, just when really confusing things happen, but, you know, I like the game, you know, being new to me. I like every game being a totally new experience. I think I want to go into the arcade, because I have plenty of money and nothing to spend it on, because it gave me another freaking item shop instead of or another freaking greed instead of an item shop. And plus, we're on the depths too. So after this level, there won't be any more item shops or item rooms. Yeah, after this level, things ramp up 1000%. So I might as well spend all the coins I have now. No reason not to. I'm hoping to get a few hearts. Two specifically. I think this is the first time I've ever made it this far in the game with this little health. Usually I have, you know, at least 5 or 6 heart containers by now. This guy's not giving me any hearts either. Ooh, a nickel. Nice. Come on, I don't need any damn keys. I need some damn hearts, damn it. There we go. Watch this be the one. I screw up. Of course. I'll try not to spend too much time in this room because this is not very interesting. Oh, Jesus. But I would like to heal up just a bit. Alright, come on. 3 times in a row, seriously? Ugh, I'm sure it'll give me the key, though. Of course. Piece of shit. Okay. This one. Yes, excellent. Too bad they're both, well, better than nothing. I just want to say too bad they're both just half hearts, but every little bit helps. Alright. Bam. Yes. Oops. Oh well. I still have 14 coins to spend, so let's see what else we can get from this guy. There is an item, a special item that you can only get from this guy, and he only gives it to you sometimes when you spend a lot of money. It's basically an item that neutralizes any fly that you encounter and makes them no longer hostile and they no longer damage you, which is pretty nice to have, but you know, not essential. But again, I have all this money to spend, so I might as well make use of it now while I can. These bombs might be helpful later on. The keys, not so much. Unless I come across chests, because of course there won't be any more item rooms. Okay. How about something useful? Hearts I'm okay with. He can drop as many hearts as he wants, because even if I don't need them, I can try to get a blood bag from that blood machine and just have hearts to ooh, soul hearts. That's pretty uncommon. Wow, that's a lot of bombs. Okay. Almost out. Jesus. It sure wants me to have enough of those. I might go on ahead and give the blood machine a try. Because if I'm lucky... Ooh. That's the, yes. Fly love. It's a piece of poop you wear on your head, and it makes flies love you. Wow, that was convenient. That was my last coin, too. Alright, let's see if we can get anything for this piece of shit. A nickel. Oh yeah, and it gives you coins every time. But obviously, if it weren't for the blood bag, it wouldn't be worth using this thing at all. Okay, one more. Let's see, 1.5. Yeah, that's it. But we got a shitload of money from that, so let's see if we can get anything from this slot machine. I know I said I wasn't going to spend too much time here, but I would really like that blood bag, if at all possible. Oh, a new pill. Well, it's not explosive diarrhea, so no point in range up. And my tears extend almost all the way across the room now. Which is pretty nice. Oh, pick up that cardigan. No, not the cardigan. The card. Again. No, not the cardigans. Not a delightful British pop band. Oh, come on. I know I shouldn't be asking for much, since I already got the poop hat. Give me something. Eh. Meh. Okay. I'm out of coins, so let's just blow this puppy up. And I'll leave the blood donation machine there for now. I might come back to it later if I find more hearts, but I don't want to risk losing any more hearts against that thing. Or that thing. Since I'm actually doing pretty well now. Now that I have these soul hearts. Okay, let's see if I can actually get this to work this time. Excellent. Ooh. More range. And my shots go all the way across the screen now. And all I had to do was put on my mom's shoes and underwear. Totally worth it. Oh god, these guys again. Oh Jesus. And we have two bomb flies. And a head. Well, that's not really a very apt description, because most of the enemies in this game can be described as a head. In the upper levels, you can start encountering the bosses just as regular room enemies. I think they're not as hard as when you encounter them as bosses. Not that Chubb is very hard to begin with, but oh shit. I need to stop saying how easy these enemies are, because every time I do that, I end up taking a hit. Wow, a nickel. A whole shiny nickel. That's worth losing. Aw, man, again? Sometimes the randomization in this game can be kind of wonky. Pretty frequently, well, not pretty frequently, but more often than you would think, I'll just encounter two identical rooms, one right after the other. It's kind of strange. I mean, this room isn't identical to the last room. The layout's different. But still, Chubb twice in a row. Hopefully I get something better from this Chubb. Wow, penny. That's so much better than a nickel. Oh man. Oh well, at least I'm at the boss. And the boss of the depths too is always the same thing. And it sucks. In fact, I'm not sure about my chances. I do have my yum heart, which is handy, but I don't have many items that are useful against mom. Let's go ahead and use my tarot card, Strength. And you might remember that shoe is the High Priestess. But it has now turned against us. We have eyeballs and skin flaps opening up in each of these four doors, as well as the shoe coming down. The eyeballs and skin flaps spawn monsters. And if you get too close to the skin flaps, hand comes down and destroys you. I'm actually not doing too bad so far. God, I need to stop saying these things. I'm doing horrible. I am totally going to die. God, I suck. Man. Why am I sucking so hard? Use my own heart. Until you beat mom for the first time, the last area of the game isn't even accessible. So, we did it. And we got a heart container, which I can't really complain about. It would be nice to get one of the better weapon upgrades in the game. The laser tears are my favorite. But I guess we just gotta make do with what we have. Notice that when you beat Mom, you can no longer leave the room after you beat the boss. You can only go down. Alright, let's enter the womb. I'm actually pretty surprised that I made it this far. Like I said, I do not record this game expecting to win. I record it expecting to lose, but, you know, to learn a little bit every time I lose. I mean, that's the motto of these roguelikes. Losing is fun. This room sucks. Ooh, man, this room sucks. Actually, I think losing is fun is only the motto of Dwarf Fortress. But I think I saw it appear in Dungeons of Dreadmoor as well. I think that's one of the difficulty levels. The losing is fun level. Let's use our heart. You encounter many new enemies in the womb. They are horrible. Some of them are worse versions of earlier enemies you find. I like to call this one the Zit. I don't know what it's officially called, but it reminds me of a Zit in some old episode of Ren and Stimpy or Rocko's Modern Life or something. Only one Larry Jr. and some guts. This room could definitely be worse. I won't complain. Let's see. Yeah, in the womb, you just want to head straight to the boss as quickly as possible. Because, like I said, there's no item room, there's no shop, there's nothing to make exploring worthwhile. The only thing exploring is going to get you is a faster death. So, of course, I don't know where the boss room is. If I had the compass, or one of the map items, that would make things easier. I think one of the maps actually shows you where the boss is. Maybe it's just the compass. I'm not sure. Oh, two of my least favorite enemies. Usually you don't see this many brains at once. You must really be ramping things up. Now that I've beaten the game 5 times. Okay, use our gum heart. God, that thing is so useful. Let's see. Oh, I have 22 bombs, so instead of wasting a key, just bomb our way into that. You can't blow through those. Never mind, I will use a key. And Steven. Apparently that's just a damage upgrade. I thought Steven was a familiar. Or maybe I'm thinking of Little Steve. My bullets are definitely larger. My range and my damage are both maxed out, which is nice. You can't always get that lucky. Oh boy. Alright. These guts are not an issue as long as I do not go next to those rocks. Worry on taking out these little shrieking things. Whoa. The guts somehow escaped from their prison. I think the presence of an enemy can alter the course that a guts takes. Why are they dying when they roll over their spikes, though? It's not fair. Coin. No point in going after that. Oh, Jesus. Okay. But I found the boss room. Excellent. The boss of the womb one. There are many things it can possibly be. The boss of the womb 2 is always the same thing. Really, I'm more worried about the boss of this level than I am the boss of the next level. The last boss of the game, I really think it's easier than Mom. But, I mean, this boss could be anything. It could be... Well, let's just find out. Oh, that was a blood donation machine. Never mind. Occasionally you can find, like, slot machines and things to spend money on in the womb, which, you know, makes having money here not completely useless, but I haven't found anything like that. So yeah, I'm not going to bother exploring the rest of this. I'm just want to get on with it. Skolex. I've only fought this guy once or twice. I don't think he's the hardest boss in the game, but I might not be remembering that well. You can only hit him in that little flashing thingy on his tail. I don't know how long that mouse cursor was in the window, by the way. I apologize. I totally did not notice that. Which probably drove some of you insane. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Well, this seems pretty manageable. Damn it, Duke! Stop saying these things! Yep. Of course. Karmic justice. Oh, another thing about the womb is everything does a full heart of damage instead of just half a heart. Oh god. Oh man. Okay. For a second I thought I was dead, but I forgot about this thing. Oh, that was close. Okay, come on. Almost got him. Almost got him. Come on, come on, come on. Die. Yes! Man, what a rush. Man, my health is low. Wooden spoon, speed up. I think my... well, no. Not all the way. Whew. Okay. Only two hearts left. Not looking good. Come on, Duke. You can pull through. Aw, man. A tiny chub. And two tiny Larrys Jr. And I don't know how I did not just get hit there. Jesus. I hit there. I knew that one. Unfortunately, my curse does not do me much good at the moment, because if I get hit, I'm dead. There's no going down to half a heart. Unless I collect half a heart, then I get hit. I'm tired already, Jesus! Another sliver of health forever. Okay. Let us use our yum heart. And continue. Oh, this is a boss that I never encountered during the game proper. Fistula. Does not take as much damage to, oh god. Oh my god. Sorry. Quiet. Must concentrate. God, my heart's pounding. Yeah, Fistula, basically is just a game of asteroids. Doesn't take as much damage to deal with in the levels themselves. Ooh. Okay. I'm gonna take a risk. Okay, good. Whew. Come on, buddy, help me out. Give me some health. Okay, not really useful. Also not really useful. Come on. Battery. Pretty good, especially with our yum heart. Oh, it immediately charged my yum heart too. Excellent. And when I used it, it doesn't actually use all of the charge. Wow. That works differently than I thought it did. I thought it just made shit charge faster. These eyes suck, but in a room by themselves, yeah. Just gotta circle straight from the death. Wow, that battery was actually pretty good. Thanks, beggar. Sorry I was rude. I was kind of desperate. But you pulled through. You helped me out, man. Okay. Gotta pop these zits. Wow, I really can't believe I made it this far without, you know, without any extremely good power-ups. I mean, I got some pretty good stuff, but none of the game breakers. Let's see, is the boss up and to the left or to the right? Let's try this way. Oh Jesus! I think when this brain dies, he explodes into the smaller brains, and I totally should have gotten hit there, but I didn't. Okay. Thanks. Excellent item. Oh boy. Oh lord. Okay. This is manageable. I'm going to be much less talkative in these last few rooms because I'm in the home stretch, man. I'm almost there. Oh. Should have gotten hit there, probably. Having a Halo Fly is one of those items that you can't really rely on it. You can't really say, oh, well, I can be more careless now that I have this Halo of Flies. But when it works, you're going to be very glad it's there. You know what game is awesome, you guys? Bomberman. Apparently, Edmund McMillan thought so too. But this is a version of Bomberman where you, well, I guess I could use bombs, but it wouldn't be very helpful because I can't kick my bombs across the room like these guys can. I can move their bombs slightly by shooting them, which is nice. This is another one of the wow. He's totally stuck on that door. Excellent. This is another one of the seven deadly sins bosses. I should have used my heart before I finished that room, because then I would have gotten an extra charge out of it. Damn it. Oh well. Oh, excellent. I did not notice that I killed that guy. Oh, fuck. Okay. This is a doppelganger. He moves like you move, and he shoots like you shoot. In many of the doppelganger rooms, there are spikes that you can trick the doppelganger into walking into. But not in this one. It's simply a battle of wits. I just gotta... Ah, shit! Okay. Okay. I can do this. I've done it before. Come on, heart. Come on, heart. Come on, heart. That's not a heart. Wouldn't it suck if it spit out a heart, but it was on the spike, so I couldn't even get to it? Boy, that would suck. But I don't have to worry about it. Oh boy. Okay. Gotta concentrate. Ooh, excellent. And I have another use for my yellow heart. Unfortunately, that was totally the wrong way to get to the boss. But I had no way of knowing. C'est la vie. Oh Jesus. Totally should have gotten hit there. Thank you, Halo of Flies. Definitely one of the most underrated items in the game. Well, I mean, I don't know how high this stuff is actually rated, but one of the more useful items in the game that you wouldn't really think about normally. This is one of those rooms where we can trick him into walking into the spikes, but with these eyes here, that makes it significantly more difficult. Okay, there we go. Oh, the world. Not the sun. Well, let's use it and get the map. Oh, man, look at how far away the boss is. Well, we can get there faster by going through that secret room. And there's a game room. Oh, never mind. I thought this was a room that I haven't already done. Occasionally you'll find a room that's just plain empty, which is nice, especially when it's down to the wire like this. Oh, Jesus. I thought I was dead. Okay, one more. I guess I could have just gone onto the item room without even bothering to kill these guys. Or not the item room, yeah, the secret room. Because you don't have to clear a room before you can bomb a hole in the wall. But it would be nice to get this out of the way. Because I can use my yum heart and I am relatively safe. I really hope there's something good in this room. And there is not. 3 pennies. Okay. Well, first of all, let's blow up this blood machine. Because I'm certainly not going to use that. Excellent. Very nice. Okay. So I have 14 cents. Spend them in the slots or spend them at the shell game. I think the shell game has a higher chance of... Oof, excellent. The shell game has a higher chance of giving you hearts than the slot machine does. Oh man, that was so nice. This feels so good to be back to full health. I am going to keep doing this because as many hearts that can drop, the more hearts that drop, the better. Because even if I'm full now, I can always come back for them later. It's a nice thing. Power-ups do not disappear. There's a fly, and fly dies. The power-ups just stay there, until you go to the next level, of course. Well, I mean, they're probably still there. You just have no way of getting back to them. Because you cannot go back a level. It's just straight down. Giving me quite a bit of money too. I would have liked to have that heart. Okay, you know what? I'm just gonna head on. I'll come back here if I get hurt. And I really need more hearts. See, I seem less... Oh, I see. The one with the eye open is faster than the other ones. I never noticed there were actually two different versions of this enemy. Okay. Now the question is, do I want to go to the boss now, or do I want to try to fill my yum heart up first? Let's fill it up. If I get hurt, I can always go back to the arcade. Well, assuming that there are enemies in both of these rooms. Because otherwise... Otherwise, I will not have enough to fully charge it. Unless my battery kicks in. See, I thought the battery just, you had a chance of it charging twice after a room instead of just once. But apparently, it works differently than I thought. Okay. Woo! Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. These enemies aren't even really that bad. They're just a pain in the ass when you have a doppelganger in the room. Okay. Is there any way I can... No, I'd have to walk into the spikes myself. Unless... No, not worth it. I just have to kill him the old-fashioned way. Oof! Okay, well, I charged my yum heart, but I took 2 damage in the process. So let's head back here real quick. See if I can get some more hearts. I hate to do this because I know how boring this is to watch, but it's important, damn it. Even though the last boss isn't as hard as Mom, at least I don't think, I still want to go in as well equipped as possible. Ah, damn it. Stupid flies. I don't think there's really any pattern or anything to this either. It's pretty much just dumb luck. I've gotten a fly every single time on this guy. Oh, thank God. Okay. I wonder if I can do both of these. Oops. Well. Ooh. Oh, explosive diarrhea. Meh. I guess I could just kill this guy. I'd have a chance to get a heart from him then. I'll do a few more. Tell you what, these 25 keys are just so useful. I have so many doors I'm gonna have to unlock. I love how I ended up exploring all of this dungeon anyway. Or all of this level. Even though I was trying to find the... I was actually trying to find the boss as quickly as possible. But no. He is in the very last room I look. Okay. Let's do one more. Okay. You obviously don't want to give up any hearts. So... Oops. It was just a bomb anyway. Another bombs or key pill, which once again, I have exactly the same number of bombs and keys. Do I actually want to keep this? No. If I try to use this against the boss, I'm just going to screw myself. So let's just get rid of it. Alright, this is it. The final boss. Are you ready? Cain versus Mom's Heart. And I already take damage. Awesome! Well, let's go ahead and use that. What you have to do here is do as much damage to the heart as possible when it pops down, and kill the waves of enemies that spawn between rounds. Actually, this boss has gotten harder. And the more times you fight this boss, the harder it gets, definitely. But as you can see, I've already... Oh, come on, die. I've already done pretty good damage to him. See, as you can see, as opposed to when you're fighting Mom, it only spawns one wave of enemies at a time. Whereas Mom herself can potentially spawn a ton of enemies and just oh shit. That was my my notification tone on my phone. It scared the shit out of me. It's pretty tense. Pretty tense. I really hope this whole thing is recording okay. I mean, I know what I did wrong last time. I actually died once before I finished the game. And when I went to click restart, I accidentally clicked the restart button on the recorder instead of the game itself. And it pops up a dialogue asking you, are you sure you want to cancel the recording? And even though I clicked no, the recording still screwed up at that point. So hopefully this time, that will not be the case. Luckily, you don't really see the really horrible enemies here. You don't see the knights or the jumping guys. It pretty much sticks to a few easier types of enemies. Of course, now she's spitting out these giant globules of blood, which makes this much trickier. I have the poop hat, so these flies aren't even a problem. They will not even fire at you if you have the poop hat. Oof. Almost got her. Excellent. Oop. Got him. Oh well. Phew. Man, that was a rush. Alright. This has been the Binding of Isaac. Let's see what we get. It is. Oh, shit. That's never happened before. Oh. I thought it was going to take me to another area. Wow. I wonder if that's actually an item that you can get, or if it's just like a, screw you. Here's the enemy roll. Oh, those pustule things are called boils. They don't really stay on the screen that long. There are the seven deadly sins. You saw several of those. Here are the bosses you can find. We only had to fight a few of these. And there's Fistula. We fought him in a room, just not as a boss. And Mom. And the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. And Mom's Heart. And Isaac. The game just got harder. Okay. Well, this has been The Binding of Isaac. Thanks for watching. And comment if you like this. If you want me to do more, I may. I have to beat the game 3 more times before I have really, truly beaten the game. Maybe the game doesn't get harder until you beat it 6 times. Because every other time, well, after you beat it the first time, it shows a triumphant Isaac, you know, and the big heart. But now, I don't know. He looks pretty panicked. I'm a little worried about what the game's gonna be like now. I thought it was already getting harder, but I guess we'll have to see what happens. So yeah, let me know if you want me to do more. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.